I was born in Kuwait. In 1990, the Gulf War erupted. So as a protective measure, they had to destroy the civil registries. And one of the documents that was destroyed was my birth certificate. 2011, I came to the Netherlands to work as a knowledge worker. And upon the expiry of the work contract, the only chance for me to stay in the Netherlands was to apply for asylum. There I was in the asylum camp, without a birth certificate, without documents, not being able to identify who I am.
We live in a world today with roughly 7 billion people. 2 billion of those, roughly, lived in developed economies. And across both the developed and the undeveloped world, a lot of the people are actually not counted. They can't vote, they can't pay taxes, they can't collect welfare because they don't have identities.
There are some old identification models that are currently being embraced by leading development agencies, which choose biometrics as the answer to uniquely identify a person. But if this information falls into the wrong hands, then we are actually putting this child at risk of future abuses and future persecution. There must be a way to do it differently, and that's where blockchain technology comes into play.
If we're going to solve the identity crisis in the world, which affects more than a billion people, I think we have to start very small. The issue is not in identity itself. I can give you an identity, but what can you do with it?
Civic is a decentralized identity platform. If you look at the world today, driver's licenses, passports, birth certificates, everything's paper-based. And we think there's a huge opportunity to just digitize all that and make it digital on your phone and available over the internet.
This is the crypto beer vending machine. We put beers into a vending machine and require age verification using a blockchain-based technology to verify that you're over 21 so you can receive a beer.
When you walk into a bar and you give your driver's license to the barman, he gets to see where you live, your age, I mean, everything that's on there, when really he just needs to check that you're over 21. By asserting that you're over 21 and not giving the machine any other knowledge, it's a real win for privacy advocates.
The blockchain, cryptocurrency, the whole ecosystem hasn't been explained very well. The vending machine that sells beer is not going to help anybody, but having a use case is helpful. It creates a bridge to more altruistic, maybe even better use cases.
This is the beginning of showing what you can do that you could never do before with a digital identity. It will add a utility to a product that really couldn't exist at scale before. And that's a lot of what we will see in the future as digital identity grows.
I'm a refugee. I am the problem owner. I am validating the journey of an identity in the feet of a refugee. I encountered thousands of Syrian refugees who lost their land titles, academic certificates, birth certificates, passports, driving licenses, and are not able to prove who they are. This is where we started Tycoon, and we designed what we call the ANA identity system that can verify what is true about yourself, about your credentials, leveraging the trust and authenticity of the blockchain technology.
The sun returned here today and revealed the devastation left by Irma.
The humanitarian crisis grows more urgent every hour.
The Caribbean was hit by Hurricane Irma last year. And similar to my story and similar to the pains that I had, the multiple registrations that I went through, the slow process of aid, the slow process of identification, the possibility of having fraud or losing your food voucher or losing your refugee aid identity. There's a group of people having it right now in the island of St. Martin in the Caribbean.
The issue with humanitarian aid is that means are usually not sufficient to help everyone. So it's about prioritizing, it's about making decisions. And the current model is quite slow.
We partnered with the Dutch Red Cross to work together on an identity wallet that can identify people, that can attest in a trusted manner who they claim to be and what did they receive in aid.
510 is a data and digital initiative of the Red Cross to provide aid in a very efficient way. The blockchain has a way of encoding trust, and it has the possibility of anonymizing the interactions between organizations. And in our case, that will help us reach scale much faster.
Blockchain has this incredible ability to help civil society and individuals act more freely, interact seamlessly, and transact in the digital economy without intermediaries.
You have doctors, you have lawyers, you have mechanics, you have people that can grow food, but without a framework for understanding who does what, you just have chaos. If people could have their identifier and broadcast themselves, you just get efficiency a lot faster.
I think that the work we're doing and seeing right now in credentialing is very important from a technical perspective, but that next stage where we really get into this web of relationships and the deep psychological aspects of identity and how a solution can actually solve that using Ledger, that's the stuff I think that's going to really have a huge impact on society.
It is funny how I came to live in the city of justice where cryptos and blockchain are supposed also to deliver justice to the world. It's like destiny was aligned for me.